What's up, guys? Josh Junta here, producer at Love Science Music and head engineer at GSI Studios in New York City. This video is meant for upcoming producers and engineers. I'm going to offer you 23 tips for working in the music industry. Tip number one is to get an internship at a recording studio. This is probably, I'd say, the most important tip of all of them. It's probably the best thing you can do for your career, because in the recording studio environment, if you get an internship, you're going to be exposed to all aspects and all types of people within the music industry. You're going to be working alongside of the producers and engineers who work in the studio, which is what you want to become. But you're also going to be surrounded by artists and managers, artist managers, label managers, record label people, marketing people, people work in publishing and licensing, and other jobs related to the music industry. So it's a great way you're going to network and meet folks and also be in the professional environment and see how things operate on the professional level. Tip number two is to always be learning. Basically, at whatever level you're at, if you're a total beginner or if you're a seasoned pro, there's always so much more to learn. So there's always new software updates, there's always new plugins coming out, you're always working on different computers with different operating systems, different studios with different pieces of gear, different microphones. So there's always more things that you need to grasp how to use. You can learn just about everything you need to know from online resources, from videos and courses. That is, if you're disciplined enough to sit down and do it every day or consistently. Tip number three is to define your goals. What's your exact goal for working in the music industry? Do you want to be a recording engineer at a studio? Just a mixing engineer who mixes records? Do you want to be a mastering engineer? Do you want to do all three of those things? Do you want to just produce, create tracks for artists to write to, just work in a certain style of music? Or do you want to do an overlap of all these things? The better you can define exactly where you want to land in your end game, you know, 2, 3, 5, 10 years out from now, the more you can define your path of what you should be doing in the short term now. Tip number four is to work for free. When you're just starting out, before you're a professional, you should just be working for free. For your friends, you should tell your friends that you're starting to be a producer engineer, you want to make tracks for them, you want to record them. Just do it. Find people who are artists who need your service and just do it for them. I remember the first project I ever did for someone else was my sister's boyfriend at the time. I recorded his band's EP. They needed 4 songs recorded and mixed. And I really didn't know how to mix at that time, but since, you know, we were so close, I was like, yeah, it's cool. The stakes were low. That's what mattered. So for $100, I brought them to the studio. We recorded the 4 songs, which was pretty much a whole day's work. And then it took me a few weeks to mix those 4 songs because I was just kind of figuring out how to mix. It got me really excited because I saw that I could complete a project from front to finish. And it gave me the confidence to move on and tell more people that I was in the game of making music. Tip number five is to become a master of one DAW or one music software program. There's a bunch of music software out there. There's Pro Tools, there's Logic, there's Ableton, there's Reason, there's FL Studio, and many more. You basically need to pick one in the beginning and get amazing at it. Learn everything about it, know the ins and outs, be really fast so that when you're in a session working with people, you're just thinking creatively. You're not thinking about how do I fix this problem, or I don't understand what the program is doing right now. Once you've got a program down, it doesn't hurt to get familiar with the others, but I'd say the main priority is to nail one program, know it really, really well. Tip number six is to create your own project. For me as a producer, when I was starting out, I didn't really want to wait around for artists to hire me to produce music. So I said, hey, how about I create my own project? So that's why I created Love Science Music. And I just started creating tracks for vocalists to collaborate with. So I could come to vocalists and say, hey, here's all this music I've been working on. How about you write to it? Let's work. Let's build some music. Let's release some music. So that kind of put me in the driver's seat with my production career, to where I was kind of in control of my creative output. I wasn't sitting around waiting for things to happen. That actually led me ultimately to working at this recording studio, GSI Studios, because one of the owners here was familiar with my work, and we connected to collaborate on some music because he heard what I could do. Have your own project, be the one creating the music and pulling people together to make it happen. Tip number seven is to mix your own music. This comes right off of what the last tip was, which was to create your own project. You should be mixing that music, and mixing is really the kind of a centerpiece of studio work, because mixing makes you a better recording engineer, it makes you better at the recording process, because in mixing, you're kind of dissecting what was recorded and picking apart what sounds good, what doesn't sound good, how to make those things sound better. Mixing also makes you a better producer, because you have mixing will give you the foresight to know which parts are going to lock together, where there's room in the whole sonic spectrum for different sounds, and how to piece all those things together. And mixing is also a super creative art. To me, mixing is more fun than recording, and mixing and production are very much intertwined. So it's a very creative process, and it's going to build your ears probably faster than anything else. Tip number 8 is to be active on social media. You want to be active on as many social media platforms as possible and as you're comfortable with. Having a lot of output is going to attract people to what you're doing, and it's also going to bring you work. It's going to bring you people asking about your rates, asking about projects, asking about collaborations, asking questions about what you do or if they need advice for what they're doing. So ultimately, you want to move from being a consumer of content online to a creator of content. Tip number 9 is to be proactive. So you want to be the person who's hitting up other people, reaching out to other people, trying to set things up. Set up a writing session for yourself. Set up a recording session for yourself. Set up a collaboration project. You want to be the person who's reaching out to others a lot, trying to set things up, trying to introduce people, trying to get people in the same room to collaborate, trying to get things happening. Especially in the music business, it's such a social industry. It's all about the relationships you have. So it's not just all an online game. You gotta get people in the same room to make things happen. So the opportunities that are gonna come your way are gonna be reciprocal of like how much effort you're putting in and how proactive you're being. Tip number 10 is to book a recording studio. This is a really important tip if you wanna go from being an amateur to a pro. If you've only really been working in a home studio or kind of like a makeshift studio, a good way to get yourself more into the music industry is to book a professional recording studio local to your area. You could even start by doing this by yourself. If you're a producer who makes tracks, go book a room for 2 or 3 hours and make a track in the studio just to put you in that environment. Better yet, you can have a client, once you have clients, book the studio. Say they want to record some vocals, you could tell them, hey, here's the rate of the studio, pay for some studio time, it's going to sound better, and then pay me my engineering rate. They book the room, you get to work in a pro studio, boom, you're a working recording engineer. Tip number 11 is to meet studio owners and studio managers. This goes back to step number 10 a little bit, but if you're an engineer, studio owners and studio managers are the people who hire engineers to work sessions. So the more of those types of people you meet at different studios, the more you're in a position to get work. If you book studios, you're more likely to get work from that particular studio. If you bring them work, they're gonna wanna bring you work. Tip number 12, have a workspace. As a producer and engineer, you're gonna need a place to work. So this could come in the form of a home studio, which would need you to get some gear and have a room set up to record in. Or it could come in like a joint shared space. You could link up with some other producer engineers or some other musicians who have a space. Or you can get involved in professional studios like I talked about in the previous 2 tips. But the point here is to have a workspace, a place where you go, you're working on music, you're not distracted by other things, you're in the zone, and it's professional. Tip number 13 is to create music every day. If you want this to become your job, you have to treat it like your job. I was talking to a friend of mine the other day who's a producer signed to Universal Records, and he was telling me as a signed producer, the label has a quota for him. Every month he needs to submit 10 tracks a month, which comes out to 120 tracks a year. It's a lot of tracks. So if you had a job producing music, you would have to meet a quota like that. So if you don't have a boss or a label telling you what to do, you need to create that for yourself. Create a quota so that you're consistently meeting a deadline of having music finished. Your value as a producer comes from the amount of music you have together. If you sit down with a singer or an artist who's interested in working with you, you want to be able to play them 10, 15, 20, 50 tracks that sound great that they can choose from. Tip number 14 is to have your best work organized. You want to basically have a portfolio of your mixes, of your recordings, of your productions, of your tracks, of your music that's released, but you want to have it organized. You want to have those WAV and MP3 files either on a cloud, like in Dropbox or on your website, or on your hard drive, on a USB drive, so that in any situation, you could be on an airplane, you could be in an elevator, you can walk into a studio, into a meeting, you're able to access your music immediately and play it for people. because you never know when you have an opportunity to show someone your music and for something to arise from that. Tip number 15, embrace being a freelancer. In the beginning, you're gonna be a freelancer, which means that you have to get your own work. You're not gonna have a salary. You have to create opportunities for yourself. It's gonna be on you to quote your own rates, to get clients, to communicate with people, and to do all this in a way that people like talking to you and like working with you, and that it's professional. If a stable job opportunity comes to you, then that's amazing. But by default, you should expect that it's a freelancer's world. So you need to educate yourself about what that means and how to navigate that. Tip number 16 is to read. This goes back to what I was just talking about being a freelancer. You're gonna need to educate yourself about being a freelancer, being an entrepreneur, how to build a business. That's your job, is to build your own business, to build yourself into more work. And for me, I personally would definitely not be where I'm at today if I hadn't really picked up the habit of reading a few years ago. I love to learn, I love to read. I recommend reading music industry books as well as entrepreneurial books. Some music industry books that I've read that I really like and recommend would be Song Machine by John Seabrook, which is about hit writing. Zen and the Art of Mixing by Mixer Man is about the art of mixing and dealing with people while mixing. Sing to Me by L.A. Reid is an autobiography of the record man and mogul L.A. Reid. Q, the Quincy Jones autobiography, I recommend. A lot of my favorite entrepreneurial books are Essentialism by Greg McKeown, 4-Hour Workweek by Tim Ferriss, Lynchpin by Seth Godin, 0 to 1 by Peter Thiel, and Ask Gary Vee by Gary Vaynerchuk. I'd say start with those books to really get your business mind turning. That'll help you out. Tip number 17 is to pick up other work within the music industry. If production and engineering isn't quite paying your bills yet, then you're gonna need to pick up other work. And you might as well pick up other work in other fields of the music industry because they're all related. Some fields to look at would be working for a record label, working for a manager or a management company, working for events company that do music events. The publishing and licensing world is great because a lot of money in the music industry filters through that part of the industry. You could work in film, you can work doing live sound in venues, or you can work as an assistant for anyone who does any one of those things. Tip number 18, socialize. So you gotta get off the internet at some point. If the bulk of your hustle is happening online, it's important to bridge the gap between your online connections and your in real time, real life connections. And getting work in the music industry or getting work as a freelancer is so dependent on trust. People, and you really get to trust people by meeting them and getting to know them face to face. So you need to do that initially a lot of times to get work, because you might connect with people online and then a lot of times the work doesn't come to fruition until there's that in-person contact and communication and trust. Tip 19, stay current. If you want to work in today's music industry, you really have to know what today's music sounds like. So that comes in the form of crack open Spotify or Tidal or whatever streaming service you use and listen to the new releases of all genres of music. Listen to the charts, the top 10, the top 50. Know what people are talking about. You see people talking about records on Twitter, on Instagram, go check out those records, see what's hot. Be familiar with the sound and get it in your ear so that you can get today's sound from your actual production and engineering. Because the thing that excites clients, today's clients, is sounding current, sounding like their music is ready for the radio, is ready for a music video. Tip number 20, be a student of music. So coming off the previous tip where I said to know everything about modern music, you also want to be really in touch with music of previous decades from the 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s. You want to know all of these artists who really pushed music in different directions, who altered the course of music and the sound of pop and contemporary music, because that all influenced what we're doing today. Because you can listen to the radio now and hear hits that sound exactly like hits from the 80s or from the 70s. So a great way to know all the classic recordings is to look up the Rolling Stone top 100 albums of all time. And they also have a Rolling Stone top 500 albums of all time. So that'll basically cover your bases with the most loved albums and music in history. Tip number 21, play an instrument or DJ or both. If you know how to play an instrument, that's going to put you in touch with the language of musicians and the language of songwriting. And that's going to make you a better producer and engineer, and it's going to make you better able to communicate with the people you work with in the studio. Knowing how to DJ gives you an amazing overview, bird's eye view of music, of how music, the momentum and energy of a song works. And after you've absorbed the energy and momentum of a song, like where that should lead. You know, it gives you a real, puts you really in touch with the ebb and flow and the shape of how a song works and where the ride that music takes you on, which is an essential skill of a producer of crafting an awesome song. Tip number 22, understanding song form. To understand song form is like the structure of a song, the sections of a song. You're gonna have to know the intro, the verse, the chorus, the pre-chorus, the interlude, the bridge, the double chorus, and the outro. You're gonna wanna be able to hear this stuff by ear so that when an artist is just telling you these terms, you know where they are. You're looking at your session in Logic or in Pro Tools and you know, oh yeah, the bridge is this section of music. So that's the language that musicians and artists and singers often speak. So you gotta be familiar with that so that you can edit and also so that you can write songs that reflect that. Tip number 23 is to let it come to you. So I just gave you a whole bunch of tips about what you can do. You know, you gotta hustle, you gotta be proactive, you gotta do all these million things. But if you're working, if you're putting in the work, you just gotta trust that it's gonna come back to you. And I found from my experience that when you put in the work, you're gonna get opportunities. But you're not always gonna get the exact opportunities you expect, you know? And they're not always gonna come to you in a way that you expect them to come to you. So you might work real hard and feel like you're not getting anywhere. But the results of that work sometimes have a very roundabout or delayed or long path to coming back to you. So you just gotta trust the process. And if you're putting in the work, know that it's gonna come. So if you made it this far, thank you guys. Hope you enjoyed my tips. And please drop a comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to chat. And you can find me online, lovesciencemusic.com. I put out a lot of other tutorials and I drop a lot of singles with different artists. You can find me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, at lovesciencemusic. So thank you. And then once you've done that, it's probably gonna take you months or years. I shouldn't say that. They're gonna be like, fuck this.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's not untrue. It's just like, he's...